And he came out there on stage, and Danny Coker said something about singing about Jesus passing by and hoping that he passed by as you sang. And you sang, since Jesus passed by, since Jesus passed by. Oh, what a difference since Jesus passed by. Never forget it, George. I've never forgot it my whole life.
God bless you, buddy.
And I have to admit, those pants were kind of funny, George.
Pardon?
Those white pants were kind of funny, as I recall. Let's sing one for the boys.
Life is like a mountain railroad.
Oh, yeah.
With an engineer that's brave, we must make the run successful. From the cradle to the grave, watch the curves, the hills, the tunnels. Never falter, never fail. Keep your hand upon the throttle and your eye upon the rail.
Yeah.
Blessed Savior, thou wilt guide us till we reach that blissful shore where the angels wait to join us in thy praise forevermore, forevermore. As you roll across the trestle,
oh, boys, that's good.
Spanning Jordan's swelling tide, you'll behold the Union Depot into which your train will glide. There you'll meet the superintendent, God the Father, God the Son. With extended hands he'll greet you. Weary pilgrim, welcome home. Blessed Savior, thou wilt guide us till we reach that blissful shore where the angels wait to join us in thy praise forevermore, forevermore.
Yeah!
I don't know of anybody in the gospel music field who's had the impact that George and Glenn and the Cathedrals have had. Their consistency, their wonderful quality of music that they've always insisted on, and their faithfulness is one of a kind. And what a way for them to go out. They went out at their very, very best.
Wonderful grace of Jesus, greater than all my sin. How shall my tongue describe it? Where shall this praise begin? Taking away my burden, setting my spirit free. For the wonderful grace of Jesus reaches me. Wonderful, the matchless grace, the matchless grace of Jesus, deeper than the mighty rolling sea. Wonderful grace, like a thousand feet, for even me, broader than the scope of my transgression. Sing it, greater for than all my sin and shame. Oh, magnify the precious name of Jesus, most defiled by his transforming power, making him God's dear child, purchasing peace and heaven for all eternity, and the wonderful grace of Jesus reaches me. Wonderful the matchless grace of Jesus, deeper than the mighty rolling sea, higher than the mountain, sparkling like a fountain, all sufficient grace for me and me.
For me.
Broader than the scope of my transgression, greater far than all my sensation. Oh, magnify the precious name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus, wonderful name of Jesus. Magnify his holy name.
Bless your heart. You know, we're better than I thought we were. Every time I turn around and look at him, I think of something.
I think about a lot of things, and I look around at you, too.
Glenn's brother Ken, said he, when he's going to school, he fell in love with his fourth grade school teacher. We was talking about how ridiculous that was. He was 11 years older than she was. Somebody asked me the other night and said, why do you pick on Glenn like you do? I said, God has called me to do this. At the Praise Guide in Indianapolis one time, there's a lady come. She's about Glenn's age. She's about 90. But I was wearing Glenn. Bill remembers. I was wearing Glenn out that night, you know. And finally, she stood up and shook her cane at me. And she said, all the time, the last 40 years I've been seeing you fellas, you tease Glenn. Over and over, you tease Glenn. You ought not to do that. You ought not to tease him like that. And she raked me over the coals good for teasing Glenn. I had a terrible time explaining to her that I'm not teasing. Should I tell them about New York? I got to tell you this. He went to New York City on vacation here a few weeks ago. And the lady who lived beside him, I'm gonna tell it. The lady who lived beside him heard he was going. She came over to the house. She said, Glenn, my son went to New York City 8 years ago. I haven't heard a word from him. She said, Mrs. Dunn is her name. And she said, his name is John Dunn. When you get to New York, look him up and tell him to call his mama. And Glenn said, okay, big place like New York, and he was going to find him right away. Glenn said, okay, I'll look him up. So he flew into New York, got in the cab, went downtown. Sure enough, when he got down, the big brick wall had a big sign that said Dunn and Bradstreet.